Welcome guys, you are here again for the Power DSP lessons. This is P Madhan Mohan coming to you from Jasmine Infotech. In the second part of this sampling series, we are going to see why the spectrum is repeating again and again in the frequency domain. It is very important. So let's move to the first slide straight away. First of all, what is spectrum? Spectrum is a representation of frequency components in the frequency amplitude axis. X-axis is frequency and Y-axis is amplitude. In this example, the spectrum is given for a very simple signal, which is a single cosine component of 100 Hz. Surprisingly, here there are two components in the spectrum. One is on the positive side at 100 Hz with amplitude of 1/2, and the other one is on the negative side at 100 Hz with the amplitude of 1/2. This is a negative frequency component. Negative frequencies are just a mathematical resource to analysis and synthesis, and not more than that. Let's stick with the same example that we saw in the part 1. Sampling frequency of 8 Hz and the aliasing frequencies are F0 plus KFS. Here we can see the tabulation in which aliasing components are given for both positive and negative values of F0 and K. K value is taken as 1. Frequency components 9 Hz and minus 7 Hz are aliasing components for 1 Hz. Frequency components 10 Hz and minus 6 Hz are aliasing components for 2 Hz. Frequency components 8 Hz and minus 8 Hz are aliasing components for 0 Hz, which is nothing but a DC component. In the negative side, frequency components 7 Hz and minus 9 Hz are aliasing components for minus 1 Hz. Frequency components 6 Hz and minus 10 Hz are aliasing components for minus 2 Hz. F0 is given from minus 4 to plus 4, that is from minus Fs by 2 to plus Fs by 2. So plus 4 Hz is aliased with 12 Hz and minus 4 Hz. Similarly, minus 4 Hz is aliased with 4 Hz and minus 12 Hz. Previously, we saw any frequency component is represented in the frequency domain with positive and negative sides with off the amplitudes. So, here we can represent the 4 Hz and minus 4 Hz signal without any problem, and it's the limit because F0 of 5 and 6 Hz and above are already aliased. See here. In the same way, F0 of minus 5 Hz and minus 6 Hz are aliased. See here. In the below table, I tried to strike out the aliasing components 5, 6 and 7 followed by 8 and then 9, 10, 11 and 12. In the negative side, minus 12, minus 11, minus 10, minus 9 followed by minus 8 and then minus 7, minus 6, minus 5. So, at last, only the frequency components from minus 4 to plus 4 we can represent without any problem, that is from minus Fs by 2 to plus Fs by 2, and the same is repeating again and again. So, here this is our spectrum of interest and these are repeated spectrums. In fact, it is extended to plus infinity this side and minus infinity this side. Fs by 2 to 3fs by 2 and minus fs by 2 to minus 3fs by 2 are the repeated spectrums in this diagram. We need to understand mathematically why the spectrum is repeating. Here I have taken a simple cosine signal x of t of frequency f0 and it is continuous, so we need to change it to discrete by replacing t to nts. Then take a signal y of t of frequency f0 plus kfs. It is also converted to discrete by replacing t to nts and then multiplying it inside. Here we can cancel fs and ts because fs is equal to 1 by ts. So finally we got cos 2 pi kn plus 2 pi f0 n into ts, which is equal to cos 2 pi f0 n ts, because cos 2 pi n plus theta is equal to cos theta. At last, we got x of n is equal to y of n. So if we consider f naught is a spectrum of minus fs by 2 to plus fs by 2, then it is repeating for all values of k from 1 to plus infinity and from minus 1 to minus infinity. I hope now you can understand clearly why the spectrum is repeating again and again in the frequency domain. Okay guys, if you have any comments and suggestions, please send it to the email id pmadhan.edu@gmail.com. This is P Madhan Mohan for Power DSP lessons. Meet you again. Until then, bye bye.